Councillor Parish.
You're being very patient with me, Madam Chair.
Yes,
thank
I am.
You. Is the patience going to end soon? Councillor Yanika opened up a channel that I want to get into a little bit. I was quoted in the papers earlier this week as suggesting that we would move a motion today to do something about Mr. McCallion. Either send him a letter, because I believed him with my whole heart that he just found out he owns 16% of world-class developments. I thought we'd send him a letter saying, would you like to voluntarily now take yourself off the paupers list and send us back the money? I since have read the comments from William McDowell, who says that he still believes that Mr. McCallion requires funding. So I'm not here to get blood out of a stone. So just so that people understand, once I find out that it's an impossible task, I don't go after it. But in the end, as Councillor Yanika says, if it turns out that Mr. McCallion does benefit from the $4 million that was paid out to by OMERS to world-class developments, there will be some recourse at the end for us to at least do it civilly or do something about it, will there not?
Again, we have to wait and see how the evidence plays out. We don't know exactly what is there, and so I can't really say one way or another until we know the full story.
You're being very
story.
Careful.
Yeah.
That's good. And you know what? I have to say, I think you're managing this whole thing extremely well. I would like the votes separated out because